Good afternoon. Welcome to First Lutheran Church for the third of our Lenten Luncheon Series. I'm Pastor Jeff Johnson. We're so glad you're here on this wet, soggy March day. Before we go on, why don't we offer a prayer of thanksgiving for the meal? Gracious God, thank you for today, and thank you for the many blessings of this life. Thank you for all good gifts, because all good gifts come from you. Thank you especially for this meal, this gathering, this fellowship. Help it nourish our bodies, and always help us to keep in mind those who have nothing to eat tonight or nowhere to lay their heads. All this we ask in your name. Amen. I'm thrilled to have Ann Beauregard here with us today. I'm sorry, got caught there with my throat. Anyway, Ann is certainly a friend to the city, a friend to Campello, a friend to First Lutheran. She is the District 5, I call them commissioners at home in Florida. And so I always confuse that here. Council person. So anyway, we're so glad that she's here. I'm just going to push her on button and let her go. Please, we will reserve time, because she obviously represents a political force in the city, time for questions and answers at the end. So if you've got questions and answers, please get ready. While I've got your rapt attention, next week is Mary Beth O'Brien, who is the principal of the Gilmore School, formerly of the Huntington School. And Mary Beth has been at the Gilmore for 2 years now. And we had her here 2 years ago as a guest speaker. And I'm just curious what's happened in those 2 years. I know she's teaming up with Lynn Smith to do an Easter egg hunt event here at First Lutheran, Easter Saturday, the day before Easter Sunday. And then Lynn Smith joins us the following week, first week of April. And finally, Steve Domish, the former editor of the Brockton Enterprise. I'm very excited about this roster. Well, I will be quiet. Many thanks to our wonderful chefs today. So give them a big hand. And everybody, please help me welcome Ann.
Thanks, everyone, for having me here today, and I appreciate it. I'm a little shorter, yes, for having me out. First of all, I want to thank Pastor Jeff, and I love the fact that this community doesn't change in a whole lot of ways, because it's still closely knit and it's positive, and I come here for different events, I won't lie to you. I love the cookies. I love the sweets. I love the cookies. Yes. And I came from St. Lucia, and I love that event that I don't know how to pronounce, but that goes on. And thanks. Thanks for keeping the heritage alive and including other people's heritage. I'm Ann Beauregard, Beauregard. And I'm the Ward 5 City Councilor in Brockton. And look at this. I brought a map, which, by the way, I have some in case you don't all spend your life on GPS. And you know, so kind of interesting here, because I border this area, and we're kind of over here with Whitman and Abington, a little bit of downtown. But the thing is when you're a ward counselor, you're still like everywhere, because, you know, we don't live in a vacuum. So I want to highlight a few things. I can be reached at 774-297-4939, or at abeauregard@coba, which stands for City of Brockton, Mass. .us. Okay? And there's a whole lot going on. It's understandable, and some of you I know come from other communities, but you have a right to know what's going on in Brockton, because it's the sixth largest city in the Commonwealth, and it's the only city in Plymouth County. So for a lot of you that, you know, live in Plymouth County, you have all of those, that information. So we'll start being optimistic here that it is spring, even though it's rainy today. And one of the things I have here is, right now, they're kicking off their tree planting situation. Okay, you have to order the tree first, or trees. Now, this includes a particular area that we're in, and Brookside Ave, and going east and north to West Elm. Okay, and all these different, with the MBTA commuter rail on Montello, Maine, and we want people to realize, I mean, this is a little bit of a unique map, and I have more of these, okay? This is part of the DCR, which is Department of Conservation and Recreation, and this is also with the wildlandstrust.org, for those of you that go online. 617-626-2000. 1503, 617-626-1503. Okay, you want trees because it looks nice, because it makes your neighborhood look safer. Do you know crime goes down when you have trees in the neighborhood? Because it enhances the appearance of the neighborhood, protects your home, it keeps it cooler in the summer, keeps it warmer in the winter, which is pretty amazing that it does that. A little oversimplification. Actually, this group is going to be having a workshop, and I think it's next Wednesday night, at or maybe it's Tuesday, at Broughton Main Library. It's totally free, and it teaches you how to prune your trees, how to preserve your trees and protect them. Okay, everything is free. Okay, there's 40 trees, styles, types, whatever, to choose from. So I think that's kind of neat. There's a whole lot great going on in Broughton. I only have a limited time, so I could be up here for about a week. But I want you to know about that. Yes. I want people to realize that there's good things going on. There's also intense things. Okay, I'm biased. Next month, this is going to be like the 28th year of the Taste of Metro South. Okay, so this is when all these great restaurants come together and all kinds of other activity. And it's at the Shaw Center. Yes, the Shaw Center has been somewhat renovated and revamped, and we encourage people to be a part of this. This is right after Easter, Wednesday, April 24th, at the Shaw Center, and you can find out more about it. It's the Metro South Chamber of Commerce that puts this together. And no, they're not paying me to do this. I just believe in highlighting all kinds of great things that go on in the city. And again, now I'm going to mention a couple other things. People can still get their taxes done for free Monday night. It's at the Broughton Main Library. Good idea is get there around 3-ish. Okay, it's from 4 to 2 they finish with people because they close at 9. And this helps a lot of senior citizens, people on fixed incomes, etc. They will do your taxes for free. Okay, and this is about the 9th or 10th year they've been doing this. Meanwhile, if you can't make it on Monday nights at the Broughton Main Library, you can go to Massasoit on Saturdays. You can go tomorrow at Massasoit starting at 10 o'clock. To my knowledge, they're in the Student Union Building. Plenty of free parking there to go in there. And I cannot emphasize this enough. And if you know people, maybe it's not you, but maybe you know someone else that needs these services, pass this along. Do you realize sometimes how you can simplify someone's life and they can have a whole lot less stress? Another thing I want to mention, too, is, I mean, a whole lot, like I said, of good stuff is going on here. And it's just amazing, whether it's an art gallery opening or whether it's it's a science fair or whether it's like I said, endless opportunities for different individuals at different stages, a council on aging, what Lynn's going to do, or Easter egg hunt next month. Then you're going to have all kinds of free things going on at the libraries, etc. It's just all in all. And remember too, if you're lucky enough to live in Broughton, you can go to the Fuller Museum anytime you want for free. And it's pretty amazing stuff because right now they have an internationally renowned exhibit, and it's, I won't lie to you, very intense. All right, one of the other things that we fought for and we got a little bit is with Comcast. So any of you that are seniors and have different situations going on, healthcare, other things like that, you can call 800-266-2278 to find out about getting some discounts and negotiate. My brother-in-law called for one deal, and he got $10 off a month instead of just $2 off a month. So keep trying, people. Okay, and this is now effective in the month of March. Those of you lucky enough again to live in Broughton, it's another good thing going on. Okay, so let's talk about some other things going on in Broughton. Again, I'm going by the Masons today, and they said, "Be part of the change you want." Now, how many times have we heard that? And it's International Women's Month, and I'm surrounded by women at this table that do a whole lot for the city of Broughton. And again, I have to be for a month to talk about how much they do. But everyone needs to realize that you can be part in your own, way of how you want to do something. What's going on in Broughton right now? Okay, never before have the house's values been so high. So hence, that makes your property taxes go up. A little general simplification. Why is this happening? For two reasons. Well, because they cost way more the further north you go and the further west you go. So now we're receiving the ramifications. Two, at this certain stages in the history of the universe, there's peaks and valleys, and right now a ton of people want to buy houses. So if you want to sell yours, good move right now. But you need to realize that, yes, you will get a whole lot for it, but I won't lie to you, it might cost a lot somewhere else to find a place to live. That's a really good thing for Brockton. What's a little challenging, and this is all over the state, is the situation of affordable housing, because many senior citizens are on a fixed income, and many young families tight squeeze right now. Affordable housing means that you're working, or you're receiving benefits, or you're retired, and you're receiving, you know, what you're due, certainly from your pension or, you know, 401, etc. And you know, want to live somewhere, and how would I say, be in a viable community. Brockton has more affordable housing than any other community in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Okay, this is good for the people living there in the affordable housing. Not good for the people that own their own homes. And that's also a squeeze too. So if people hear me say, no more affordable housing for Brockton unless there's already a contract signed, I'm gonna stick with that because it's not fair to the current homeowners. We want our schools to be the best because our kids are the best, and you just talked about how you're gonna have this great principal here next week, and she could tell you that why you want the best for, you know, your students. Because a community with great schools is a great community for everyone, okay? And last but not least, infrastructure. Now, infrastructure is not glamorous, but boy, are we not giving it up anytime soon. That means indoor plumbing, and that also means roads, bridges, etc. And there's been, and because we live in the Northeast, they get walloped more so than if we lived, you know, down in, you know, southern Florida or something. So that's what we need to concentrate on, and we need the revenue in our city, and that's why you will hear me chant repeatedly, no more affordable housing for Brockton. We want market rate, and we want luxury, okay? But we're not really pushing for a ton of housing either, because we want other things. So that brings me back to yesterday. There was a groundbreaking for the first of luxury apartments in decades. We're pretty excited about that. They took a building that needed to be, unfortunately, demolished because of its neglect. It had been in a fire, we were looking at, what, like 11 years ago or something? And they took care of it. So we're gonna see this. Yes, luxury apartment, high-end market rate, you know, in downtown Brockton. And what people need to realize is this can happen, and so can a lot of other good things, okay? So that's one of the things I wanna highlight. I am adamant about keeping our history and highlighting it, which leads me to two things. One, we have a historic commission, and we're trying to get members on it or people's input. Please do not hesitate to be part of any kind of board or commission, or even come to any of the meetings. They're all public, and they're all open to you, okay? The more you know, the better off you are. And the second part of this is, we're honored here in Brockton to have, and we're the only other community that has had this, is Boston. The library on Saturday, no, it's May 18th now, will be hosting Mass Memories. And this is huge. This is through UMass Boston. And people can come. Please do. If you lived here, you grew up here, you live here now, with your pictures, with, how would I say, artists, especially some of you that had a grandparent that worked at a company that doesn't exist anymore, because we all know we were the shoe capital of the universe, but we had a whole lot of other stuff going on. They want to keep our memories alive and bring it out to other people. And that's important, because if you can't learn your past, then you can't go forward and you can't recognize, you know, what's happening in your present. And I just, there's so much great history to this city, and it's terribly exciting that we can be a, you know, part of this. And people don't realize that the guy that started Hollywood came from Brockton, and it's called Hollywood because that was his last name. And people don't realize that. People don't realize that we've had the first person to receive an honored award during World War I was a nun that came from Brockton. I mean, there's a whole lot here. I mean, I could talk to you about the Historical Society. I could talk to you about all the, you know, the art and the monuments in this city. But, you know, I hope that you take the chance to experience yourselves. People want to know what's going on? Okay. I taught you about the affordable housing. I taught you about the boards and commissions. Some other good stuff that's going on. There is supposed to be. I always have to say supposed to, because until it truly happens, We're supposed to get another apartment building with a bakery on the first floor, sounds good, huh? At 26 School Street. And then we're seeing some activity talked about at the intersection of Crescent and Quincy and Massasoit Community College. We're honored to have the first woman president at Massasoit, and Gina is ready to have input from all the community. She wants people on advisory boards, so please, you know, come on and check this out. This is also, there's a college in Ward 5. There's also a hospital. A hospital is over 100 years old and growing. I can tell you right now, the Brockton Hospital they show you in that small picture when you come into the lobby is a fraction of where they're going now. And they're going to continue to grow. That means quality services medically for you, or you don't have to go into Boston. That means quality services that you don't have to pay in an arm or a leg to park. And that means that you can be close to your loved ones during a very challenging time, because let's face it, it's a pretty scary time when cancer comes along and other diseases. So this is really encouraging. Across the street is Apothecare. They used to be right next door, but they're growing by leaps and bounds. So they're expanding, okay? We're seeing a little bit of expansion. We have a whole lot going on in Brockton. It takes a lot longer than we wish. So I did want to highlight a few things. I did want to mention, too, that for anyone living anywhere, National Grid is going throughout the Commonwealth, because after their little snafu with National Grid and I always want to say Bay State Gas, Columbia Gas, they're going to want up the ante with their bills. Next, at Thursday night, they're going to be here in Brockton, and they're going to be at one of the middle schools, and I'll get that information out to all of you, that at 7 p.m., and everyone is welcome to speak and express their concerns, and I just want to emphasize that. I'm going to go back to when I talked about boards and commissions, and if you cannot attend a meeting and they want to put a junkyard, let's say, right next to your house, of course you don't want that, justifiable, okay? You cannot make that meeting because you just had knee replacement surgery. You understand that at all times you can write a letter, you can email one. It has to be read into the minutes because this is a public meeting. You can be heard if you can't make it. And I want to emphasize that. I also want to talk to you about, we're lucky enough to live in this freest nation in the world, and it has its challenging moments, but again, right now, the Senate is working on their budget, and then it'll be the House, okay, but there's a bill up here that if you'd like to call, most of you are lucky enough to have our State Senator Michael Brady, 617-722-1200. They love it when I give out this number, okay? And you can contact him and say you want him to support Bill 861, the clear case for a public infrastructure bank, because we need our roads repaired and we need them sooner than later. That is the number one request in this city from homeowners. And believe me, I know they're totally justified in it, and you get a little heartbroken to say, okay, we've got to wait here. Have no fear. I've been begging at the State House. I've been begging at the federal level, and I will continue to do so because it shouldn't have gotten to this point. Now that it has, we have to take emergency measures. And again, we encourage businesses to come here. If there's some challenges that people have, or they know their, you know, cousin wants to open some kind of manufacturer, come and talk to us. Do I have all the answers? By no stretch of the imagination. But what I can do is connect you with the people that do. And that's what I feel like. I am a public servant. Wherever I am, whether it's at Shaw's and someone has a question, but they live in Ward 1, or if I'm at, you know, a concert or something. By the way, you know that Brockton High people are like blow your mind talented, and we have these phenomenal concerts and musicals, and people say, I want to know about this. We're doing anything in our power to not keep anything from you. We have the city's website, and it's going to be upgraded, and I do my own segment once a month for 10 minutes, Ward 5 and 10. Yes, sometimes I go over, but most of the time, no. And I do have guests. If any of you would like to be a guest, because you have valuable information to pass on, which I don't doubt, please let me know. 708-774-297-4939. Now, if it's all right with everybody, I'm going to open it up to questions. I hope everybody's registered to vote. And I hope that everyone has enjoyed themselves. I hope everyone has a safe spring. And know that if you want to get involved, if you have a passion, or if currently there isn't a group that holds your passion, we'll work with you to see that happen. So I'm going to open it up. We're to the left here first.
Thatcher Street, what happened to that?
Okay, I'm getting a question here. Thatcher Street, okay, there is St. Joseph's Manor, there's Massasoit, and a whole lot of people live on Thatcher Street. Right now, that's in the courts. There was a lawsuit put against that because, again, somebody wanted to put 175 units of affordable housing, and people have challenged that because, one, it's way too much for that little lot there. It's a little larger than we imagined, but still. But two, because we have met our quota, and right now at the state level, they're looking for affordable housing other places, and it's time for someone else to do their share. I'm sorry. And Lynn?
Budget. Are we in budget season yet for fiscal year 2020, and what are our challenges going to be?
Oh, well, our challenges are always that we're growing. Things cost more, and everyone can relate to this one. Health insurance never gets any cheaper, and that, you know, affects all the employees, retirees, etc. Costs of services in other respects, whether it's simple, you know, gas, auto repair, whatever. Which leads me to this little commercial interruption. We have a subcommittees in our city council, and one of them is called accounts. You might want to come to the meeting. The next one will be the day after Patriots Day, which is April 16th, okay? And everyone can come at 6:45, and we'll probably be in the GAR room at City Hall, and you can listen to us go over all this, who spent this money for what, and get the backup on it. We're not keeping secrets from you. It's a lot of times, it's challenging to decipher. So this whole question is true. There are challenges because we want more revenue coming in. So even though property taxes are higher and people are paying more taxes, things still cost. What we're trying to do is getting more industry. So we have a company coming in that makes its own cigars and distributes them throughout the country. And that's in downtown Broughton. It's in a small area. And we have a couple of other opportunities for companies to look in. We're hoping to become a little bit of a mini biotech area right near Good Samaritan Hospital, right off the highway. So fingers crossed on that one, because it's way more expensive to have property in Cambridge than it is in Broughton, and these companies are starting to look at that. So that's terribly encouraging. So yes, challenges are, first of all, that we are expecting to have two new positions because they're long overdue. One of them is, we're calling it the sign guy. We have more streets, we need more caution, crosswalks, etc., signs of that nature. Somebody has to put them there. They don't land there during the night. So we really need to have a full-time person for that because of the expanse of this city. And because no matter what, some of them get knocked down. So that is going to be up there. I mean, that's $50,000 a year for a salary, but we have to talk health insurance, etc. The other one that we're looking at seeing too is with procurement. Now, those of you, if you're not familiar with this, if the city wants to go and has to replace a photocopier, let's say it costs $1,200, they don't have to go through procurement. But if they need to replace a roof and it's going to cost $80,000, you're just off the top because some of these buildings are relatively large, not like a house. They have to go through what they refer to as an RFP to let people know that the opportunity for a job is out there. And this can all be, you know, known to the public. And it's always in the legal section of the newspaper. Find a lot of stuff in the legal section of the newspaper. So that is, we're going to need another individual to handle that because so much growth is transpiring in Broughton. And I know sometimes you say, when are you going to see it? And believe me, I'm one of those people. Okay. That is why. And before I forget, we're going to have another exciting item, too. We want to get more commuter rail service in the city of Broughton. So I have a meeting next week with one of the people from MassDOT, which stands for Mass Department of Transportation, to find out how we can wheel and deal to get more opportunity for more transportation in and out of Boston. We have a great deal of medical professionals that work at a lot of the hospitals in Boston and around here too that don't exactly do the 9-to-5. And then we have people that like the Red Sox and like the Bruins and whatever, and they don't want to drive in there, so they take public transportation. They can take the commuter rail back or something, and that's why we want to make that more accessible. We're also, people always say the young professional. I call them people that come in at different stages of their lives and might want to live in an apartment and not drive as much, and that we're seeing a lot of. We're also seeing some changes, and I do want to highlight, too, we had a big meeting a week and a half ago with a property called CSX, and this was a railroad property. It's no longer used as a railroad, and there were all kinds of ideas talked about with this. And again, this was a forum, and it was interesting, the input that people had. But one of the things we're also pushing for in this city, and we're really adamant about it, is protecting our property, conservation, environment, and making more, how would I say it, aesthetically pleasing. And I used an example, copy what looks good, okay? A lot of people have heard the Emerald Necklace in Boston, so kind of working on some sort of idea like that. I mean, again, I can be reached at 508-584-6919. That's my backup number, 774-297-4939, or aborgard@cobma.us. Just realize, we're here to serve you, and if you live in Ward 1 and you have a question, you can call me. I'm not going to tell you, oh, you live in Ward 1, I can't talk to you. Okay, and, you know, I'm in 5, but I'm all over, and if anybody else has a question, please. Oh, gentleman in the plaid, sir?
You were one of the few city councilors who was opposed to the Boston Casino proposal. At this point in time, that proposal is not dead yet. It's still being talked about by the developer.
Yes.
In Boston. What are our chances of preventing a casino from being built in the Boston Bay?
They're really big, and right now, you know, we follow that. I was vehemently opposed to a casino across the street from high school, let's all be real, especially from a company that was already in trouble in 2 states. Okay, but having said that, yes, I'm extremely vocal, and I was at the Mass Gaming Commission back in the spring, so, no, actually in the fall, I'm lying, because they had put the whole issue of Regency, that's what they call our area, on hold for 2 reasons. One, because they wanted to see how well things were going to go on in Springfield. And two, because we still have the issue with the federal property in Taunton with the Native American tribes. So now, the latest thing I saw was last week, you know, the information, the agenda, and the minutes. And because they're dealing with the episode with Everett and the gentleman, Steve Wynn, W-Y-N-N, we're still on hold. For 2 reasons. One, because they're doing that. 3 reasons. Two, because Plainville is kicking off their horse harness racing in a couple of weeks. And three, because they still want to do a market assessment of whether we need one here. So right now, we can't go to bed at night thinking it's dead. But believe me, it's on life support. So that's rather encouraging. And I'm sorry, you had a question too.
Yes, I have a friend that's vacationing in Georgia. And on Fox News, he was surprised to hear that Brockton is a sanctuary city. Is that true?
Brockton is not a sanctuary city, and this definition is all over the world here. Okay, right now, we're trying to get, you know, a lot of people are working on this Trust Act, and the reason being trust is in understanding and being acceptable. Okay, we're not a sanctuary city. I'm sure that there are undocumented individuals all over, and in this city just as well. Okay. Now, having said that, what people need to understand is that being undocumented is a civil, not a criminal offense. So that's why there's two types of courts, and that's why there's one entity. No, we are not a sanctuary city. I am sure a lot of people, and we're still in the steps to make it more of this, they refer to it as Brockton United. And what they want to do is particularly help victims of domestic violence, survivors of domestic violence, that are in a situation where they would be afraid to call the police because they came here illegally. Now, again, we don't encourage people to come here illegally, but sometimes circumstances arise, and you're at a different spot in your life, and we hope that certainly something will be worked out, you know, and through the steps. And I don't have all the answers to that by any means. Again, all these means, this falls under ordinance, our laws, are open to the public, and anyone can come.